One of the most interesting things about Haiti is the fact that it has such a remarkable history. You know, it was the first independent Black republic, the first country in the Western Hemisphere to gain independence from Western imperial powers. It shows that this country has been able to rise above everything.
How do you make an impact in a country that's struggling to develop? Well, any development economist will tell you, you start with education.
Helping isn't really a question of charity or selflessness. It's a question of duty.
The Vassar Haiti Project began with an idea, really a possibility. It was it possible to buy original art in Haiti and bring it up to Vassar College in the middle of Hudson Valley and to sell it and to raise money and to then be able to take that money and put it back into Haiti to support a project or a series of projects in Haiti. The projects that we support are in the village of Chermette. Chermette's about 100 miles northwest of Port-au-Prince in Haiti. It's very remote. There are no roads in Chermette. There's no electricity. There's no running water. And it's the most beautiful place you can imagine. The mission initially was about nutrition, education, and the arts in Haiti. And the mission still includes that. It still is about those things. But it's also now about supporting health in Chermette, and really more broadly, it's about supporting the sustainable development of a village, such that their village can be thriving and sustainable unto itself, so that if the Vassar Haiti Project were to just go away, that they would be strong and resilient and thriving all by themselves.
The other part of our mission is also empowering the students here at Vassar and also community members to think beyond themselves and how to make an organization work. While we're doing all of this in Haiti, we're also, you know, constantly working on developing the students to become leaders, to take on initiatives, and to hear their ideas and actually implement them.
Working for Vassar Haiti Project, no matter how stressful it sometimes gets when we have events, when things go wrong, when there's too much going on at the same time, to always remember that what we're doing is really, really good and that we're working for something that's bigger than ourselves.
When we read figures and facts in newspapers and magazines, or even in books and academic articles, it's very discouraging to think of, well, where do you begin? To address problems, where do you begin to help other people? And I think for me, the Vassar Haiti Project has really helped me to find that starting point.
This small thing, you know, made such a big difference to the perspective of our members because they saw that it doesn't take much to make that difference. It just takes a bit and you have to talk a bit about it and put a bit of effort. And that effort means so much in a country like Haiti.
I think as far as the community is concerned, the Haiti Project has provided a forum and an outlet for people from all walks of life in this area to just come together and contribute in ways that suit them best.
In the beginning, I was just, you know, another hand. But in the very beginning, there weren't that many hands. So from the get-go, I would help with the actual art sale. And at that point, it really was just an art sale. There weren't any additional projects going on. There were no initiatives. It was basically selling art to raise money to provide teacher salaries for this community down in Haiti, this village called Chimay.
The project, which when it started out in 2001, was just, we were just going to do an art sale at Vassar and raise a little bit of money. From there, it went on to, let's build a school, and we built a school. And then we went to Haiti, and then from that we came up with these initiatives. It's just that, it's just the power of the people involved, them pushing it forward. So in terms of guiding principles, I guess we just want to do better.
We assessed health needs in the village, basic health needs. We did measurements, weights for weights and heights of kids, and charted them on growth charts. We sat down with the school director and the school board and some of the teachers and had a conversation about what Shermet needs, like what's next. But some of their goals, most immediate goals, were having a cistern to collect rainwater, getting a pump to pump water up from the stream because it's on a mountain, so they have to go down and get all the water and carry it up. The water there from the stream needs to be purified, so we need to get a water purification system. They want to reforest around the area, and we talked about trying to plant fruit trees and coffee trees so that they'd have also sustainable nutrition. We talked about maybe putting solar panels on the roof of the school so that they can have electricity so that they could hold events there at night.
I think the Vassar Haiti Project raises awareness about Haitian artists, raises awareness about poverty issues in Haiti, raises awareness about, you know, the importance of education, about the right to have rights, about human rights.
It's not even that we're purely sending them donations. We're accelerating their development by promoting a local industry and by promoting their culture.
By buying art from Haitian artists, you know, at cost, at market prices, we're able to, you know, stimulate that kind of a demand. We sell them here, we add value by framing them, we auction them, and we send all the money back.
Everyone who is involved in BHP, everyone is there because they want to be there. Nobody makes a profit. Nobody's being paid, least of all Lila and Andrew Mead. What we do in Haiti, like helping the artists and giving them not only business, but kind of empowering them through their art, that's, I think, very unique because there's no middleman and there's no one who's kind of reaping any benefits there who shouldn't be. Like, it's really, truly the people of Haiti who benefit from what we do.
Our project is so clear and so direct, and everything is so tangible that it's impossible not to come across the results.
Every year we've had more and more participation, and every year we've been able to raise more and more money for the schools that we support. And one of the reasons for this is Andrew and Lila have been very good about allowing, you know, decentralized initiatives to spring up. You know, there's definitely that culture of if you think it will make a difference and you're willing to put in the time to make it happen, go for it.
I think if I was allowed to dream, I think that the project would definitely be something that extends out of Vassar borders. I think people will be inspired by what our project does.
I think it's a big thing, but I can only imagine in the next few years how big it will be.
We like to think that that we run the Vassar Haiti Project like a family. And a family where there's no person who is more important than any other person. Everybody's equal, and everybody is loved and cherished. And so that, and that everybody knows that, that we value, and that hopefully that Haiti values the work that we're doing. Lila and I certainly, and a lot of the students now also, bring a lot of passion into this project. And I think the passion is infectious and contagious.
Something inside, I think, like that's inside each of us that wants to make a difference in the world. I think it's like a need almost, like one of our basic instincts. And it gets covered up by life, but there is this need, you know, why are we here on Earth? Why are we doing what we're doing? Like, we don't really know why we're here. And a project like this kind of, it's not that it's the answer, but it's kind of, it's the journey, it's the road that kind of helps people get towards that answer.
The first two lines of a poem by E. E. Cummings is kind of, have been really resonating for me, and it's I carry your heart, I carry it in my heart. And I think that the students and all of us were carrying Haiti, you know, in our hearts, around with us. And that's really what I see when I look in the eyes of our students these days.
The trip in March, it's going to be our second trip there. It's going to be definitely a bigger trip than the last time. We're taking close to 15 people. It's going to be a mixture of Vassar students, our community members, people from Poughkeepsie who are heavily involved in the project, and our Andrew and Lila. And this year, the trip is going to be focusing on what has changed from the last trip in terms of how is our money going there, what are the changes that have been made, and what are the further things we want to do.
We are going to work with the children and kind of meet the teachers and the students, teach some English, and talk to also inhabitants of like nearby villages to talk about our initiatives such as reforestation, water purification, and the medical initiative. We're kind of going to assess basically everything that has been like worked on in the last year.
The very first thought I had was that this was the worst tragedy in history in Haiti. Instantly, I knew, having lived in Port-au-Prince, having knowing it as I do, and living it as I did, I knew that a magnitude 7 earthquake there was akin to the tsunami of a few years ago. You know, the hundreds of artisans and artists whom we work with were okay. That by and large, as far as we know, they themselves survived, but that almost all of them, I mean, as many as 95% of these hundreds of artisans and artists lost their homes. And a couple of their gallery owners said, though, they had basically the shirt on their back is what they had left.
We know that it's an ongoing problem. It's not going to be something that it's 1 month. It's in the news. It's exciting. Everybody is asking about Haiti. The needs for Haiti will go on very, very long term. They have for years, and they still will be. And we're going to be a part of it long term. It's not just in this moment in time.
I do know that some of them went right back to work. Reynald Joseph does paintings with a lot of energy and action in them. And he painted almost immediately a triptych, a three-piece painting depicting the earthquake. So, you know, from what we've seen, the artists have been very eager and anxious to jump back to work. Partly because obviously it's their income, and partly because it's an important moment. It's a tragic moment, but it's also a very important moment. We also realized that we wanted to do our mission. We wanted to be true to our mission, and we wanted to do more. And the only way we could possibly do that was to step up. And what the Vassar Haiti Project is about, in a nutshell, it's about people being bigger than who they are. And so in this instance, we basically told the group, told the students, told all the members that, you know, we really need everybody to step up. If we're going to do this, if we're going to respond the way really we want to respond, and the way I think people thought we should respond, is that we all need to step up and be bigger than we already are. And everybody did that. The best possible thing you can do is to put people back to work. If you put them back to work, they can rebuild their homes. They rebuild their homes, they can rebuild their lives. So we've been buying art like never before.
We went to Haiti 2 years ago, and we took a small group. We took 9 people all together. On this trip, we're taking 16. What happened the last trip and also this trip, especially since the earthquake, is a lot of fears came up about why are we going to Haiti and what are we doing? Are we going to be a burden on the infrastructure of the country? And it's a question that you have to live with and that you have to keep thinking about. And what we're asking the students is just to bring their best selves forward. We're going to look and see what needs to be done. We're going to be with the people, because that's the most important thing. Ooh.
sabe
yo. Esto no es por nosotros.
Anali.
No la voy a tuner.
We went into Haiti, we were thinking that the need was so overwhelming and how could we ever fulfill it. But then I saw the little boy, and I saw the little girl, and I saw the family, and I saw the village, I saw the school, and it really struck me that the difference that we're making, no matter how small, it is worth making. To even just, if you can't help the whole country, just one village, one school, one family, one person. It is worth making that difference.
I think what was most profound for me was to just be with the people and with the children.
And I was just so amazed with the power and the energy of the people. There's so much hope in this country, so much more than I think anybody expects.
Attention. Attention, plus vite. Attention, plus vite.
We could learn a lot from them in terms of our spirit and how to just appreciate everything in life, because they're just such an appreciative and happy people.
It may seem weird, but it seemed as if we are growing with Shermet, and it's not two things happening independently, one project here and one school there.
It really taught me that they have so much joy in their life, that they get joy out of just being, where, you know, everywhere else around the world, our mistake is that we want to find happiness in having.
No matter how much we think we're bringing to them, it's nothing compared to what we're learning from them, to what they're teaching us about life, about just being in the world.
Sim, não.